Locked inside the ice and permafrost of the Arctic is a ticking time bomb. As the world's advanced economies battle to rein in their greenhouse gas emissions and consumption, beneath the cold, dark depths of the Arctic Ocean, there's a substance that could upend all our climate efforts, leading to a rapid runaway warming. We're talking, of course, about methane. Methane has a warming effect 80 times stronger than carbon dioxide over 20 years. With the United States Geological Survey listing Arctic methane destabilization as one of the four most serious scenarios for abrupt climate change, it could alter life on Earth as we know it. In this video, we're exploring this frightening methane bomb, discovering if these trapped stores of this potent greenhouse gas are at risk of releasing, and what that means for life, civilization, and the future of planet Earth. Listen to the global climate conferences or prominent activists like Greta Thunberg, and you'll hear endless tirades against carbon dioxide. Methane, however, rarely gets mentioned, yet it's amongst the most potent greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. Methane is an odd greenhouse gas. Although it's more potent than carbon dioxide, it degrades far quicker, exiting the atmosphere after 12 years on average. Such discrepancies make it difficult to compare climate effects. In a nutshell, if the same volume of methane and carbon dioxide were released, methane would have a far greater warming effect in the short term, rapidly falling off. In contrast, carbon dioxide's relative effect would remain stable for centuries. Nevertheless, atmospheric methane concentrations are around 150% higher compared to pre-industrial levels, contributing to approximately 20% of the total greenhouse effect. However, when methane concentrations are drip-fed into the atmosphere, its high turnover rate prevents us from getting too concerned. What is worrying is the prospect of a large, rapid injection of methane on a scale unprecedented in human and maybe even climatic history. To find such a store of methane, we need to look north, far north. Descend down through the frigid depths of the Arctic Ocean, and you'll discover vast frozen methane deposits over a large area of the continental slope, off the East Siberian coast. For millennia, they've remained stable as a solid called methane hydrates. Such a chemical state requires specific pressures and temperatures to exist. Tip either of these factors, and boom, the hydrates are converted back into methane and start bubbling towards the surface in a mass methane explosion. It's this prospect keeping climate scientists awake at night. It's not the only source of methane. Another potential source is in the Arctic permafrost. The word permafrost was coined by American geologist Simon William Muller as a portmanteau of permanent frost. It does precisely what it says. At least, it did. Unfortunately, the frigid Arctic conditions that kept the below-ground mixture of rock, soil, sediment, ice, and organic material solid are beginning to thaw, as the Arctic experiences soaring temperature rises, compared with the rest of the planet. Permafrost is a big deal climatically. It's the largest global carbon reserve, estimated to contain 1,400 billion tons of carbon, nearly double the amount present in the atmosphere. With warming temperatures, Arctic methane emissions have skyrocketed from 0.5 million tons to 3.8 million tons a year in 2006. By 2013, it pumped out 17 million tons. One nightmarish study estimated that 1 gigaton, or 1,000 million tons of methane, could be released by 2100, from permafrost soils alone. Combined with the potential release of methane hydrates, it's an apocalyptic scenario. But just how bad is it? What can we expect of the Arctic's methane problem? Is it just a load of hot air? To predict the future, scientists turn to the past. Research published in early 2021 examined two critical periods in Earth's climatic history: the last glacial maximum, around 20,000 years ago, and the Eemian deglaciation, 130,000 years ago. As Pierre-Antoine de Sandier, one of the co-authors, explained, the Eemian episode is very important because it was a strong interglacial in the Arctic, with very similar climate characteristics to what is happening today. The idea with the Eemian interglacial is to compare that with what could happen in the future. Seafloor methane emission is important to consider for modeling spatial estimations of future climate. The team ventured to Svalbard, a remote archipelago within the Arctic Circle. After analyzing vast ice cores capturing the Earth's forgotten past, they revealed that as the ice melted and pressure on the seafloor lessened, methane was released in violent spurts, slow seeps, and a mix of both. Because of the effects of microbes, which simultaneously gobble up and release methane, the team could not estimate the methane release's climate impact, nor the volume of methane that eventually made it to the atmosphere. Other estimates of the current stored methane's potential warming effect are disturbing reading. You'll often hear climate doom mongers state that releasing only 1% of the permafrost methane would trigger sudden warming of about 1 degree Celsius. Such a temperature rise would cause a dramatic alteration in the world's climate, accelerating our current predicament. 1% is equivalent to 15 gigatons of carbon. Such a release would cause 1.1 degrees Celsius of warming in the short term, declining to around 0.4 degrees on a century-long timescale. It's not all bad news. Much of the carbon in the permafrost wouldn't be released as methane. We can expect between 50 to 75% of the organic matter locked in the permafrost to decay after thawing. And most of the bacteria and fungi devouring this organic matter release CO2. Nevertheless, the proportion of carbon released as methane will be around 2% of future emissions. It's enough to increase the permafrost's warming effect by approximately 40% this century, but not enough to cause a 1 degree Celsius temperature rise. At worst, the permafrost could result in additional warming by 2100 of approximately 0.5 degrees Celsius. It's significant and dangerous, but not civilization ending on its own. Far more concerning is the methane hydrates. These Arctic methane deposits are starting to release, according to scientists aboard the research ship RV Academic Keldysh. Most of the bubbles recorded were dissolving in the water. However, methane levels at the surface were still 4 to 8 times above expected values. At the moment, there is unlikely to be any major impact on global warming, explains Swedish scientist Orjan Gustafsson, but the point is that this process has now been triggered. This East Siberian slope methane hydrate system has been perturbed, and the process will be ongoing. These new methane leaks should set global alarm bells off, though world leaders are unlikely to have heard of this obscure geochemical event. But it's not enough to declare a worldwide emergency just yet. Some of these methane leaks have likely occurred for thousands of years. Modeling also suggests there's a lag time of hundreds of years behind global warming before significant destabilization of these deposits occurs. Finally, although 8 to 17 teragrams a year sounds a lot, it's small fry compared to the ongoing average global release of 558 teragrams a year. More research is needed to confirm the scale of these releases and to estimate any potential climatic effects. However, it is an early warning sign that current warming is already having an impact. This instability in these deposits is most likely caused by the Atlantification of the Arctic Ocean, whereby warmer Atlantic currents penetrate further north. Moreover, Siberian temperatures were more than 5 degrees Celsius higher than average in early 2022, an event made at least 600 times more likely due to human-caused emissions. Indeed, in January 2022, methane recordings were off the charts in the Arctic. Satellite data demonstrated reading greater than 2,300 parts per billion, maxing out the equipment's ability to measure it. Although much of the release appears to be from Siberian gas fields, it's still a concerning trend. It certainly caused a stir in the scientific community. While estimates about methane's release by 2100 soothe nerves, there's a broader question about the survival of the human race. By 2200, it is estimated that about two-thirds of the Earth's permafrost will have melted, releasing 190 billion tons of carbon dioxide and methane. The results will be catastrophic and likely irrelevant. As we've seen, the effects will ramp up even in our lifetime. Yet despite the talk about a 0.5 or 1 degrees temperature rise, we often fail to grasp what such a world would look like. In a business-as-usual scenario, which assumes a continual growth of emissions, we're on track for 4 degrees of temperature rise. If the worst predictions about methane release are accurate, it's almost guaranteed. Picture this. The Sahara has vaulted across the Atlantic, turning southern Europe into desert. Pakistan and South India are abandoned as permanent drought grips in the region. The permafrost regions of northern Canada, Scandinavia, and Siberia are a sanctuary for the world's climate refugees. Much of the eastern seaboard of the US, Mexico, Central America, and Brazil is gone. Everywhere, migrants head north or south to escape these soaring temperatures. Western Antarctica will be viable for colonization. Alongside New Zealand and the cone of South America, it will be the last habitable location in the southern hemisphere. Climate naysayers will call it doom-mongering and fantasy, but it's happened before. In fact, the last time CO2 levels rose this high, there were beech trees in Antarctica. Who knows how the climate will react to a mass release of methane over a decade or less? To prevent such an apocalyptic scenario means rapidly reducing greenhouse emissions and stabilizing the Arctic permafrost. Scientists working on the problem proposed two inventive solutions: grazing animals and plants. In a 2020 paper published in Scientific Reports, the potential of hoofed herbivores, such as herds of horses, bison, and reindeer, to prevent the thawing of the permafrost is highly viable. These animals increase snow density by trampling the ground, increasing the insulation strength during winter. It could help protect 80% of current permafrost-affected soils. Such efforts are already being trialed at the Pleistocene Park in Russia. But to yield a greater impact, it will need to occur on a Pan-Arctic scale. Researchers from the University of Edinburgh suggested another option. Plants like trees, shrubs, and mosses play a vital role in controlling soil temperature. They shade the ground from the warmth of sunlight, and their roots extract water, leading to drier soils that are better insulators. There's a potential to radically expand the plant cover in the northern climes, thereby stabilizing the permafrost for decades, even centuries to come. The team plans to explore further how this plant cover affects potential methane release. It's time to start talking about the Arctic methane problem, With the UN establishing tipping points for irreversible climate change, we need to thaw the conversation about methane. But it's not the only source of methane. With global livestock responsible for 14.5% of global greenhouse gas emissions, it's time to think more broadly about the causes of climate change. We can't afford inaction. Hey, thanks for watching. Want to suggest a video or have something to say? Let us know in the comments section below. Check out our climate change playlist for more videos like this one.